safely get started. The current crop of viewers has changed a little bit since our last gathering. We got the state management viewers out, and we've done a couple of updates to EAP, and we just recently got one out for the Terranino maintenance build, and then had to withdraw it, and we're about to put it back with a fix. There was a problem with clicking through transparent things that wasn't working correctly. That's been corrected. We'll get that back out very shortly. Be watching for that. In addition, we still have the EAP, another maintenance, and Love Me Render in RC. We have Bakes on Mesh in RC, which is going to get an update as soon as we update the back end one more time. Well, hey, you know, it happens. So those are all in progress, and sort of perking along. Load counts and crash counts keep falling on each update, so we're hopeful that they will continue to evolve well. And let's see. There will be a blog post shortly, I think, about our outage Wednesday night. It was something we had hoped to avoid, but didn't quite. I won't try to steal the thunder of the blog post. It's very informative. Oh, it is up. Okay, thank you. Yeah, we were upgrading routers, and it. Yeah, I knew that was coming. I didn't know it had actually been posted. And it didn't go quite as smoothly as we hoped. But the ops team was on top of it, and they got things back together fairly quickly. So, we try to avoid those, but every now and then, plans don't work out. Oh, sorry, Naran, didn't know that was even possible. That I think is the basic state of the world. So the floor is open. Oh, there was another reminder I was supposed to make sure I... Oh, yeah. We've gotten a couple more. Yes. Emoji support. Thank you, Willie. That was just what I remembered I was supposed to say. One of our fairly frequent feature requests is that people ask for emoji support in the viewer, in chat. And that's not something we kind of have the bandwidth available to do. But if more like what Ryder is describing. If an open source contributor wants to dig into the dig into the rendering, the font system and all that, and figure out how to make them work, we'll work with you. So we're inviting that contribution for anybody who's anybody who's interested in taking that on. So any of you bloggers out there, this is not a promise that we're going to have emoji support soon. It's an it's an ask for a contribution, because we need somebody else to do a bunch of work before we can integrate it. No, no, we certainly won't allow chat only. So, and it's got to be cross-platform. My guess is that most of the popular emojis are available in most systems, because every chat program uses them, except Second Life in World Chat. On how the UI should look. That's a good question, and I'm not the right person to ask. So if you want to start that conversation, we'll rope in Alexa, who unfortunately is not in today. I don't know either, Kitty, but if you'll send me pointers to what you're using, I will be glad to get a judgment made on that. Yeah, well, that's why we're asking for a contribution for it, because we don't have time to work on it. We're trying to get things like EAP and Bakes on Mesh done and out the door, along with, of course, other surprises we haven't told you about. Well, you know, the trick about all that is there, if we give people the ability to write their names with all the correct character sets for their own language and their own the little diacritical marks and whatever else that other languages use, we pretty much automatically give them the ability to write display names that are as crazy looking as some of the examples we've just seen. You kind of can't have it both ways. Well, you know, if we're going to grow Second Life to be bigger and better than it is today, which is what we are committed to doing, there's an awful lot of world out there that doesn't use the ISO Latin 1 alphabet. Well, on metric, I'm with you, Naren, but I think this isn't the time or the place. Kitty, are you referring to a viewer crash? Yeah. Well, don't poke anybody, just file a JIRA. If you can give us some hint as to what the stack trace looks like, we can look in our crash browser, and that might be the easiest way to identify it.
Could be related to some of the other investigations around region crossing, too.
Right. Yeah, I haven't looked at Bugsplat in the last few days myself, but we certainly can hunt it up if it's showing up in that many of the crashes. That's what, 1/40th. It should jump right out. Oh, good. That's helpful, Worley. We'll poke around in our Bugsplat data. I'm afraid I have to agree with you, Beck, or as my mother always put it, each to his own poor taste. One of the things I like about Second Life is the incredible diversity here. I mean, we got the real world beat 6 ways from Sunday. Don't most viewers have a way to switch off using displaying things with display names? Ours did at one point. I don't fiddle with options much. Yeah, just turn them off if you don't like them. Naran, just make sure that if you do that, that you index it by agent UUID, not by agent account name. Just a friendly reminder. Any decision on offline group notices yet? Don't know where we landed on that. I think the plan is to try turning them off. That is, not forwarding group notices to email globally at this point, because it's the only thing we can do quickly. We don't intend to change anything about private IAMs going to email. Nothing new, anyway. Yeah. Our hope is that no longer not forwarding group notices will cut down on the number of people whose systems or whose actions report that as spam. Plus, let's face it, a lot of group notices are spam. It's just that we're forwarding them into email. Yeah, we'll keep the IAMs if you turn it on and if you've got your email address verified. We have some new stuff coming out for events, so that'll be cool. Right. One of the things that a lot of people don't realize is that if in Outlook, you drag a message into the junk mail folder, it reports back to the back upstream that was spam. And so you're not, people don't even necessarily realize that they're creating these reports, and often they're automated. So the feedback is automated. It's not even something that they know is happening. Well, you know, we all unfortunately need help. I mean, the amount of email that's really annoying stuff that's not bothering me is gigantic, because my automated filters do it. And once in a while, they catch something they shouldn't catch. That's the way it goes. It's a price I'm willing to pay. Naran, I don't check my spam folder very often, so I couldn't tell you. Oh, well, if that's what you did, you're going to start losing more IMs again. Only they'll be random instead of only the inventory offers. It's not actually safe to send something in an inventory offer if somebody's offline, because they might not just not get it. If they're over their limit, they just won't get it. Yeah, you wanna only send when they're online. Inventory offers RIMs. Updaters are a different question, and I don't know how Caspers work. Yeah, we'll definitely try to fix the bug. Well, I'll look into it. Maybe I'm wrong about the inventory offers, but that's what I think is true. I haven't looked at it in a long time. What is bug 41379? I should get some kind of a so the 41379, which is, for those of you who didn't follow the link, is a problem with script state not surviving a forced logout. That is in the issues collected for an ongoing project. So we're working on it. I don't see a commit for that yet, but it is getting some love. Yeah, we don't need a transaction ID because the cap already knows it. But we'll look into it. It's on the list to get attention. Premiums do have a higher IM cap. Any other topics that need discussion? Queries? Unfortunately, pasting URLs in this chat doesn't count as making a contribution. Thank you. Well, the EAP project has already taken other open source contributions, so if you think you can contribute to it, by all means do. We want to get it out. Thank you. And before we break, I also want to refresh my reminder that we have an open rec for a senior graphics developer, and we also have an open rec for a senior server-side QA engineer. So if you want to help us move faster on all the projects you care about, get somebody to come do those jobs for us. We really appreciate it. Yeah, well. It is time for me to go get ready for my next meeting. So I need to head out. Yeah, well, down to the pub would be good, but that's a little bit further out. Thanks very much. See you, everybody.